in the Philippines, you may not know, we already have the Solid Waste Management Act or Republic Act 1903, which requires the barangays to segregate those waste. But at the end of the day, the challenge here, as you have seen from almost 10 years ago and until now, is that they are incapable of doing so. There are some pilot barangays and cities and towns, but at the end of the day, if you sum up, we can never reach like 10% in the whole country. So encouragement is very important, and sustaining it and enjoying them to participate is one of the big challenge. Second, in terms of your technology requirements, because you are converting this waste into plastic, as you may say. So does your investment more or less amount into $15,000 fits in having that kind of technology?
The first question that answers, so how do we sustain that encouragement? It's a human nature. They give them money. If not money, any kind of help, when it goes, vision is according to the value proposition. I know it would be tough. And the second thing is, we read the report of Solid Waste 10-year management that was there in the DRT Ulapan. Actually, they are trying to segregate, so they are promoting it. There is no plastic school holidays and stuff. But it's not being practiced because people don't have dustbin at their home. And even if they have it, it shouldn't be recyclable, biodegradable, not biodegradable. How does a normal person know that what plastic is biodegradable and not biodegradable and how to segregate it? So the dustbin that we give has actually plastic, soft drink box, bottle and stuff with images. So that's easy for them to put it. And they will put it because we are actually giving them incentive for that.
Yes, yeah, I understand. Giving money is a very tricky proposition. ADB has been giving a lot of money for 50 years, and the Philippines also are giving a lot of money. And I'd like to tell you that there are a lot of pilot projects who fail in terms of livelihood programs, so on and so forth, because giving money is one thing, but enticing and coming up with strategies and everything. Giving money, well, so we can give money if we have money. But if the strategy is not there, because if I don't find value of participating in the idea, well, I have to bother myself. That's one thing. You have to position yourself in a manner that not only money, but you need to educate and intensify education. People will have to understand that my little contribution to this initiative will have impact at a bigger perspective. That's one thing, because if you're just giving money, ADB can do that anyway. So that's one thing. And technology is very important. I haven't seen what kind of technology you are using and how much it's a cost. So that's one thing, because if that technology is available, or maybe not to you, you can import some, maybe you have to need some, so that we can have that technology here. And then, of course, because you're trying also to have that truck. I'm concerned whether you buy the truck or you need to rent that truck.
So the first thing about encouragement, the value that we give is the top performers of waste collection and waste helping work will be there in the community, listed in our chart, in our website. They will be gifted for top performers of the week, top performers of the month, and then there will be this event in which they will be awarded. So it's a encouragement. The second thing about technology, so we are ready with the blueprints and stuff. It is a good moment by the news in Chicago, maybe preciousplastic.com. Preciousplastic.com is every material, blueprint and stuff. If you don't buy it, we make it. And with all the costing that we found out, it's $6,000. The second thing, third thing about the trust, sir. We read the 10-year solid waste management plan in the DRT Ulapan Metro office. So the thing was that in 2014, they had said that the blades and the off shedder was old and the truck was old, so we need a new one. So they have already procured four, out of which two are in use, two are in not, because it does not have a particular system. So what we aim to use is, first we use, that's why we started low at four, because we use the truck of municipality in close coordination with municipality, and then once we are giving back to the community welfare, maybe we give them trucks, and we expand to 10 and 12 around the side.
The $60 price might just be too much for the 20 to 30 year old market. We want to reconsider that or study a bit further on the pricing of your product. And at the same time, just want to comment, you may also want to consider looking for a more sustainable strategy for promotion other than it might be selling invoices and all that, because sometimes it's a common strategy of different social ventures, social enterprises, but it's not sustainable at all. One celebrity will just post about their product and all of a sudden they will be hyped, but it won't be sustainable.
We're out of time, so I guess that's enough. Maybe that one statement and we'll proceed.
The price that we put 60 was, I just want to clear that bamboo recyclable products that are being sold at previously in different markets, and the premium that we sell is at like 70-150, so it's premium but at low cost. So it's like a better deal for the youth than to get the premium thing but at low cost.
Okay, thank you very much and congratulations again. So now we call on